I already showed how you can use the secure boot by entering a PIN during the boot up, but sometimes this is not really handy. For example, if you need headless booting, so without a display and without a keyboard. For this, the hash policy was made. It's based on system fingerprinting. I will show you what you will need to change in the existing system that we had to enable the hash policy. But first, let's quickly check the process and what did we do before. Before we flashed the Raspberry Pi OS in the 64-bit version, we copied the right 64-bit files to the boot partition and we entered some lines in the config. We also set the protection profiles for the partitions, for example, flexible read-only for the boot partition and protected read-write for the main partition. Then we activated the protection by setting a PIN and setting the superoperator PIN. In this video now, I'm going to show you how we can change this behavior to use the hash policy. To change from the PIN policy to the hash policy is quite an easy task. We only need to go to the card. So I just select here again so that I'm sure it's the right one. It's saying it's locked, so we have to disable the data protection. So I enter the superofficer PIN. Now the device is again in transparent mode. The only thing I now need to change is I have to write the random access memory, not the cyclic, but the normal random access memory. And in this case, we want to override PIN with hash and uninitialized. And we need to commit. After this, you should see the size in bytes 18. And now there's just one special thing that you have to be prepared for. So if you activate the protection, then you will need to enter a 1, 2, 3, 4 here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is not a security issue because during the first boot, after the hash was calculated, this will be overwritten. But the 1, 2, 3, 4 needs to be known so that the device can override itself. The superoperator PIN you can set to any value that you wish. But this one needs to be 1, 2, 3, 4, otherwise it will not work. We now activate the protection and now put the card to the Raspberry Pi and see what's happening. So I now take the card with the activated hash policy and activated protection to the Raspberry Pi and we will boot up. You now see the U-boot, you see that the card is locked, you see that the U-boot found the hash policy, and now during the first boot, it's taking a feature of the Raspberry Pi as well as parts of the firmware in the boot partition and calculate a hash and stores it inside of the NVRAM. And after that, the PIN will also be not 1, 2, 3, 4, but it will be overwritten with some value that is depending on your fingerprint. So now, during the first boot, everything's all right. There was no need to enter a PIN now during the first boot, and the system will come up just normal. So I now will call the system and boot again, and we see what's happening. Now I'm powering up again. And now this initializing is not happening again, but now it's only checking if the hash is correct. So it's also generating the system fingerprint and comparing it with the system fingerprint stored in its NVRAM. And if everything is okay, the system is booting up like normal. So let's take out the card and double check if the PIN is changed. So I reinserted the card, select it, it's still locked, and now I try to enter the PIN. So it was 1, 2, 3, 4 in the beginning. And as you can see now, this failed. So the PIN 1, 2, 3, 4 is not working anymore. So now it's some random value that nobody should know. And if I want to deactivate the protection, this is still possible. And also to read the hash value here. So here you see now hash uninitialized is gone, but the actual hash is hidden. So you cannot read it in the normal state. So we would first need to deactivate the protection and then we can override that value. So now everything is in transparent mode and I see hash here. And if I wanted to change this device again or lock it again up, then I would need to say hash uninitialized and I would be good to go.